time is it? You know what time it is. It's time to hit that subscribe button. You know just where it's at. Right down there. Right down there. And it's time to find my Instagram. It's GeeklyAmanda. G-E-E-K-L-Y Amanda. It's the same on Twitter. Go follow me over there too. It's time to get this reaction video. Someone requested this and I was like, oh, I want to check this out. Five unknown facts about the Draupadi. I mean, I know some with, I did that video reaction when she was trying to, they were trying to embarrass her and declothe her and, but I want to know more about her. I like her. I do. I love some Draupadi. And then, I mean, I watched Mahara Hobbit and played by that Pooja, beautiful. She was had the special friendship with the Lord Krishna. So let's check this out because I want to know about these unknown facts. Unknown facts. Y'all ready? Go. This is going to be interesting.
On popular demand, we are back with a few more videos on the Mahabharata. Those of you who enjoyed our previous videos, especially the one with five unknown facts about Mahabharata, Simply Chuma presents five lesser-known facts about Draupadi. Let's get on with the list.
All right,
but
ready.
Before that, the customary reminder of you pressing the subscribe button and the bell icon, which is right next to it,
Simply
to get
Chuma.
Instant notifications of our latest videos. This is not a ranking video, but more of a list. Number 1. Hindu religious text Vayu Purana says that Draupadi was a combined avatar of five goddesses. Goddess Shyamala, wife of Lord Dharma, Bharati, wife of Lord Vayu, Sachi, wife of Lord Indra, and Usha, wife of the Ashwini Kumaras. Lord Brahma cursed them to be born as humans on earth. They prayed to Parvati for liberation, who blessed them to be born as one woman, so that they remained on earth for a very short period. Hence, Draupadi was married to the Pandavas, who are the manifestations of the gods.
The brothers.
Number 2. Few other religious texts say that Draupadi was Vedavati in her previous birth. Ravana made advances on Vedavati while she was in deep meditation. She sacrificed her life by jumping into the fire. In some versions of the Ramayana, Vedavati is reborn as Maya Sita, who
born
took Sita's place
fire?
And was abducted by Ravana and suffered his captivity while the real Sita hid in the fire. Mm-hmm. At the time of the fire ordeal or Agni Pariksha, Agni took back Maya Sita, giving back the real Sita to Rama. Lord Rama also advised her to go to Pushkar and do penance. At the end of the penance, she became Swarga Lakshmi. Number 3. At the end of her penance, Lord Shiva, pleased with her, granted her a boon. She repeated her request, Patim Dehi, 5 times, and Shiva blessed her to have 5 husbands in her next life. Hence, she was born out of the fire to King Drupada. Few other sources say that she listed out a few important qualities. Dharma, strength, archery skills, good looks, and patience that she wanted in her husband. As it is not possible for one person to possess all these godly qualities, in her birth as Draupadi, she married 5 men with each of the qualities she desired. Number 4. When Draupadi realized that she had to be married to 4 other Pandavas along with Arjuna, she prayed to Lord Shiva. He blessed her that at each sunrise, after she took a bath, her virginity would be restored. Lord Krishna added to that by saying that she would spend a year with each husband. Others would be forbidden to enter the chamber in which she and the husband of the year were staying. If one did so, even accidentally, would be exiled for 1 year.
Didn't they all,
Number 5.
She, like, take
according
a year
to Punjabi folklore, Pandavas had agreed that only one brother must enter Draupadi's chamber at a time. Mm-hmm. And during that time, no other Pandava must enter her chamber. On violating this condition, the offender was to leave immediately for a year-long exile.
Oh, that's what
the brother
year
who
exile.
Entered her chamber was to keep his shoes
that's
outside
what,
the door.
Gotcha.
One day when Yudhishthira was in Draupadi's chamber, a dog stole his shoes from outside the door.
Oh.
Unaware of this, Arjuna entered the chamber.
Oh,
according
Arjuna.
To the agreement, Arjuna had to leave for the exile.
He did.
Embarrassed, Draupadi accident. Became furious with the dog that had stolen Yudhishthira's shoe, thereby cursing all dogs, that all the world would see them copulate in public, stripped of all shame.
Oh, she cursed the dogs.
If you haven't seen our previous videos, especially the ones on Mahabharata, do not miss it. If you like this video...
Oh, I knew it. That was the year. I kept thinking she went off for a year and then came back after the year. No, but if he entered the chamber, they would have to go off for a year in exile and then come back. And I know Arjuna. He came by the accident and had to go do it. I'm just fascinated the more I learn about all of this. I'm just fascinated. Like, I spend now too much time just going through, watching videos and learning about it and reading stuff. All right, y'all. Let me know what you think. Comments, thumbs, and all that. Till next time. Mwah!